lot of, you know, functions in the rest of the world that get to, or development issues, which I think it was basically done by initiative of major technological companies interested in development, their businesses in the urban environment, and the forum of New City Foundation, which will be held in Switzerland. Well, it was actually the initiator of a new forum, the first forum about new cities and about introduction or integration of new technologies in these new cities. Also, I had met and spoke with my colleagues from a similar comparable project in Paris, well, a project known as Paris-Saclay, very similar to Skolkovo. And prior to that, I had an exchange with head of our Urban Development Council about the problems we are dealing with. That's why, for our better understanding and introduction development of our topic, I'd like to introduce four channels or four frameworks in which we didn't work quite closely, as you probably could already feel from yesterday's and today's presentation. Okay, the first framework, basically dealing specifically with which objects we're dealing here, how we call it. Well, I have an impression that here in Russia, we're very inattentive and very loose about the names of subjects or objects. That's why women talk about Skolkovo about city, as about the campus. We may call it innovative center, or create some other, you know, innovative city, technopolis. And we come up to the impression that, well, nothing depends on the name which apply to Skolkovo. But if we move on to the space, some other environment where people are using exact and precise definition and feel quite uncomfortable when they don't have clear understanding of the name of the object, because they cannot apply appropriate instruments.
The name creates a rather noticeable inconvenience. We spoke about this with John Pister. He, as the architect and the urban developer, he is always concerned with this topic. He told me that many people who know that he works with Skolkovo, they ask him, what is this? Please determine, define this subject. This site is clear, it's not a campus, and it's not a city. What is this? I'm not sure that we, together with you, during this workshop, generate the answer to this question, but I can clearly say that if we don't give the answer to this question, we then will never explain what's going to be, what's necessary in Skolkovo in terms of infrastructure and what's not to be here. We don't have serious criterion for this selection. It means that we can fit Skolkovo with such a number of the facilities such as hospital. What does hospital should do in Skolkovo? But anyways, we can load it, we can load our technopark, we can load our university, we can load our housing zone, we can load Skolkovo with museums, music theaters, movie theaters, and can do all sorts of things, and can take it competitive, because it's clear all these facilities should be maintained and paid for at the end of the day. Wishing the best and incorrectly identifying Skolkovo, we can make it not just inconvenient for life, but very expensive. In that sense, not luring. So innovations that will happen here will be just expensive or more expensive than in some other place. So we need to keep this in our mind whenever we make new proposal, like Anton was making today, describing. He perfectly knows that we didn't give the answer to this important fundamental question. So quite frequently we are swimming. We make mutually deleting, excluding statements. So we need to keep in our mind. The second issue, how we see Skolkovo. There is at least hypothetically, virtually three shells. Skolkovo itself has the closed zone because it is determined by the law. It's territorially separated space. It's important from the standpoint of counting benefits and taxes. Also at the same time, there's big Skolkovo, of which Anton, answering my questions, already started to talk. For the purpose of understanding, this is a territory that is four times bigger than Innovation Center. What's a pity? We, as people not attentive enough, attentive to you participants. So maybe we didn't think that we should take motor coach and drive around here, ride around here and see what will be the plans for development of Big Skolko. But the fact that in this territory we have several quite important for modern history of Russia, but individuals such as first Vice Prime Minister Igor Shuvalov, his building is seen from the school. On the other side, there's a big territory developed where Roman Abramovich is building his residence. Across are the golf course that are adjacent to Skolkovo. Further is residence of Suleiman Kerimov. It's also one of the billionaires of Russia, and also nearby he finishes construction of a school, of the general education school, that will be so much fitted with the sports facilities that everyone should be envied. Also under auspices, one of the residents of Skolkovo, there's a baccalaureate school. This is the also in prime school and preschool. This school is managed by the guys from Turkey, but it has already certain representatives in Moscow and St. Petersburg, and probably somewhere in the Commonwealth countries. These people are concerned with the idea to have quality medical infrastructure. There's housing is being built, there's big, how to say it right, to big parks, to forests. Practically, these are very clean forests, because in this territory, in the past, there were country house of the leaders of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union, so nothing was built here. So environmentally, it's ideal territory. You cannot find any better. So all these people, they wanted to create in Big Skolkovo ideal countryside, or the countryside that is in principle possible. And of course, while creating innovation center, we have to realize how we distribute load between Skolkovo and the other territory, because it should be communicatively connected. Even now, we are in the Skolkovo school as the element of Big Skolkovo, and we understand in our solutions quite frequently this experience drops out. We don't oriented it. We have very serious worry that while design of the Skoltech University, we make mistake of the school. We will create such a big number of the spaces that will never be filled, and they will create illusion of counterproductive emptiness rather than productive space where people can meet, communicate, and where so-called spontaneous collaboration can occur. So we have to clearly understand with whom we. As for Moscow, it's even more strange story. Skolkovo, and that was president's project. Of course, it was above Moscow. That's why even the marketing was very strange. Skolkovo was promoted. What's Skolkovo? Skolkovo is a village. How can you promote Skolkovo for international community? Saclay is also a village, but guys in France, they joined Saclay with Paris, so it's Paris-Saclay, and with Skolkovo only in future will be merged with Moscow, not administratively wise, but rather in the sense of organization. This is an extremely important topic, because for development of entrepreneurship in Skolkovo, presence of concrete problems that are to be solved and that exist on every step, such megapolis as Moscow, and repeat in every city of Russia, and in majority cases of large cities of the world, it's like a field. It also points at absence of ideology focused at innovation project of Skolkovo, and we have to clearly understand this. So separation of infrastructures from Big Skolkovo, from Odinsovo and Moscow, is extremely important framework for answering the question what infrastructure is needed inside of Skolkovo that we can explore and what we can't explore. So it's difficult to imagine innovation center where majority of people are not dealing with innovations and have indirect relation, and they will work mostly in service industry. It would be very strange. But it happens all the time. For instance, in one of the best cities, where the best, maybe, Russian oil company, Lukoil, is based in Kagalim, every seventh person, it's like Vagit Alekperov told me recently, every seventh person works in this activity, and six others are working somewhere else. Do we want that type of scoquesis productive or not? The next question is on the next framework. Next frame is the question about the type of residence. We, as if it seems that we know and we can list them, but we don't know who represents their interests, who can speak on behalf of entrepreneurs, because it must be a person who already have analyzed and reflected this position. So we know what is necessary. We know that if today we survey the entrepreneurs who came to Skolkovo and look at this group from the standpoint of its image or self-image, rather, we will see that this group is quite seriously changed. First of all, when we started this project and our colleagues sociologists conducted research trying to describe this type of entrepreneur, we saw that this is mostly people who represent fundamental science. There were few entrepreneurs, such as 10%, and 90%, these were people from fundamental science. So at the first stages, Skolkovo had to be, we were supposed to have built accelerators, huge research centers with heavy equipment, these logics, as its inertia, and we will see at the Technopark project that quite frequently we think about Technopark as big research center, not the place where the company is from entrepreneurial standpoint developing. But step by step we saw that the structure of the Skolkovo residence, first of all, companies, is changing. More and more entrepreneurs come, and less representatives of the fundamental science. Although we still have many rather dominating community of the fundamental science people, we need to understand and quickly figure out that in 2020, when all this thing is built, if we want to have successful Skolkovo, the fundamental science would be represented at minimal scale, and entrepreneurship will be represented at maximum scale. It means if we don't orient at them today, rather, if we don't move from ideal concept of what entrepreneur should be, and rather we would survey the representatives of the companies, will have distorted picture, because it will not create dynamics in such way we can make very inflexible Skolkovo. And we can address to our future students, but we understand that because of their life experience, this bunch cannot represent itself. So we rather have to switch the center weight to culture and see what will be the student's life here and what is necessary to make this life the most productive and efficient and so on. So here at our seminar, we actually have to represent those groups. So we thought, what are these groups? For us, extremely important is the group that represents the interests of such so-called top residents, such as professors, R&D leaders, the people who worked in many corners of the world and they perfectly understand what social and cultural infrastructure is needed to make their life and activity productive. And this is the first group. And when I finish my presentation, I would like to make it a topic of discussion at one of our five tables. So someone should speak on behalf of professors. I already said about students. Praise the Lord, we have so many university reps here. I'd like to form a group that will be speaking on behalf of the students. Also, extremely important to have a group that speaks on behalf of entrepreneurs. Praise the Lord, we have them. Not many, although very important to have a group that maybe will be representing our community to lesser extent. This is a group that would represent engineering activity, and it will also be formed around one of these tables. And the last group is the families and children. Someone should speak on their behalf. We have Lena Sokolova. She will assume this function. If someone joins her, that will be great. I think these five groups, as the groups that represent widely clients' interests, they could be very important to us. Why it's so important after I finish? Reallocate throughout these five tables. So we have to assemble five groups when we will be leasing presentations of the district projects. Very important not to have general judgments, but we need to have statements focused at a particular client group. Tell me, please, do you understand what I mean in the last part? So every will have to form groups, and our discussion and our critique should be focused. Further, we will look at to what degree these interests are contradictory or conflict-based, or how doable and how they can correspond to each other. All right, yes. And every group shouldn't be more than 9 people. If you don't have enough time to carry your laptop to another group, you have to determine that you're a member of another group. This is actually where I finish, so I'm ready to listen to your questions. Ignore them. In any case, we together here, we cannot represent all interests here. So I thought that it's important to focus at the core groups that influence productivity of Skolkovo. And then later, when we more or less explore them, we will put together new groups and talk about it. So we'll broaden the space. I don't want to make it so broad, so it doesn't fit in our minds. Well, I have microphone, I can have very quick question.
Living here and how we feel, or should we imagine ourselves as being living somewhere in the world and maybe consider to move to Skolkovo? What would expect from Skolkovo then?
I must say that in our first research, we surveyed the people who could have moved from abroad to Skolkovo. We learned their preferences and compared the preferences having to do with making decision about relocation from those people who live in Russia and could move to Skolkovo, with those who live outside of Russia and could move to Skolkovo. Out of these two groups, they have different imaginations. Further comes the question, such as what group should be given preference. In my point of view, we should give preference to this group that is responsible for culture transfer, because the requirements used against this place is part of their characteristic cultural form of organization of innovation process that should be installed in the Skolkovo per se. To answer your question. Any more questions?
So the question raised over there is shouldn't we introduce a group miscellaneous? Because these are the groups we think of now, but I think these do not make a society. So we need also the people who do retail. So they should be attracted also to Skolkovo. We need the people. We need the artists. We need everyone. So is these five groups, isn't it a kind of preconception or a preoccupation? And because of that, we will not be successful in the end. So this is the question.
So Окей, let's take into account 6 групп будет тогда, окей. Не возражаем, да?
No objections. As for engineers, as for the rest, it's clear. What do engineers do in Skolkovo? What will they do in Skolkovo? They materialize innovations. The people responsible that their designing activity takes form of tangible thing. So they work in university, they work in R&D, they work in startups, naturally work in university. University, despite having name science and technology university, it means research with academic component and technological in terms of engineering and designing. It still has certain focus and emphasis on engineering, technological entrepreneurship. So engineering and technological is most important. And we know that between research activity and engineering, the fundamental activities, they're based on different concepts of results, criterion, and purposes. So let's divide.